it's going to be the last question that relates to your book, but I think these, like, what was it, like five sentences made like a huge impact, and I loved it. And I really would like to see, you know, get to know a little bit of your, what it is that you do. So I'll get right into it. So one of the things that you said was that a successful marriage is a two-way street. Now, that sounds, okay, yeah, we know that. But of course, that's what you also say. Like everybody says, it's 50-50. And then you mentioned straight, and that just came in, just whack. It's like, no, if you want your marriage to work and you want to have the strength for the tough times ahead, it must be 100-100 and not 50-50. I was like, wow. That's so true. So can you explain this philosophy that you have a bit more, and especially what are some of your 100% efforts that you do that stand out and that you can see that are different from how most men go into the 50-50 relationship?
So in order for a marriage to work, it has to be 100-100. No one can have one toe in the pool and then the other foot standing outside the pool. You got to dive in both feet. Both of you do. The thing that you have to keep in mind though, is you have zero control over what that woman does or says or anything. And she is her own person, right? The difference is that you have to be committed, right? Both of you have to be committed. What I mean by that, so you have, one of the things that my wife and I do, and we had to learn this the hard way, is different people have different love languages. Okay. And so how I receive love is very different from how my wife receives love. And maybe how you receive love is differently from how I do. So what most people do is they will love their spouse in their own love language. This is another thing about awareness. Same thing with core values. Most of us will go to our grave and we have no clue what our love language is. And Gary Chapman wrote a book called The Five Love Languages. And they are physical touch, words of affirmation, quality time, acts of service, and gifts. So different people receive love differently. I can tell you for the most part, you need to go to, if you're a man, you need to go take this test. And if you're a woman, you need to go take this test. And if you're a man taking this test, you need to send this test to your wife. And then if you're a wife, you need to send this test to your husband. And just Google love languages test. It'll come right up. After you've taken that test, it's a lot like your core value. And the test takes like 7 minutes. It's very easy. After you've taken that test, you'll have a lot of aha moments, just like in the core values exercise, just like in the obituary exercise. You'll be like, oh, no wonder. Like, no wonder when my wife kisses me, like, I just feel like on top of the world. No wonder when my wife compliments me, I just feel like I'm on top of the world. And your wife will be like, well, God, no wonder when he empties the dishwasher for me, I feel so good. Or like when we go out on a date and he's not on his phone, like, I feel so amazing. Or like if you get a gift, like a sentimental gift, like a bracelet with your kids' initials in it, you feel on top of the world because you're like, oh my gosh, that is just an amazing gift. I'm always going to have it. But we don't understand that. How this shows up disastrously in our marriages is, so I am a physical touch and words of affirmation, you know, touch me, kiss me, I want to have sex, all that good stuff, just like the typical guy. Also words of affirmation. And I didn't really understand this until I had John Eldridge, who's the author of Wild at Heart, on my show. The main need, the foundational need of every man is validation. It's validation. Validate. We want to know that we are doing a good job. We want to know that we are valued. We want to know that we are appreciated. We want to know that we are respected. It helps us feel masculine. Bradley Cooper, who played Chris Kyle, an American Sniper, he's a huge American actor. He was interviewed because he's probably one of the, you know, he was voted one of the most attractive men in the world, I think, at one point. And they did, People Magazine did an interview with him. And he's, I think at the time he was either married or he was committed to a girl, I can't remember what. But one of the questions was, you must get hit on just constantly by women, you know, just throwing themselves at you. How do you stay faithful? Because he's a faithful guy, from what I understand. And his response was so profound, and it speaks to all men. And he right away, without hesitating, she makes me feel like I'm her man. And that's what my wife does for me. She makes me feel like I am her man. And there is no better feeling than that. She respects me. She appreciates me. And she's not afraid to tell me those things. It feels very good. Now, for all the women who are listening, and I'll get to the men, don't worry, but a good way to completely castrate your man and demasculate your man is to put him down and to take appreciation and respect away from him, to call him names. All these things will literally, it's like shooting a man in the leg and then he falls down and then kicking him in the face. That's what it feels like. Now on the flip side, if you're a man who puts his feet up and your belief is the woman should do everything and all you do is make the money, your woman is going to feel the exact same way. She's going to feel used. She's going to feel like she is the slave of the home. And that's not the way women want to feel. So how this can show up disastrously in our relationship and how it did, a physical touch and words of affirmation. So I had no problem with kissing my wife, hugging my wife when she was doing the dishes, coming up behind her and putting my hands on her hips and kissing her neck and all that good stuff. And then of course I was very complimentary. Oh, you look so beautiful. You're so this, you're so that. I just pouring compliments in her constantly. And I always would wonder, like, why is that like always my go-to? I just don't understand that. Like, my wife, on the other hand, is quality time and acts of service. So all the while when I'm doing the physical thing, she's like, gosh, bless you. I'm house of four boys. It's just another male figure that wants something from me, you know, or like, you know, you haven't even done anything to help me out. Like, why do you want sex? Like, I don't even feel like I'm loved right now. And I just didn't understand that. I'm like, but I'm loving you. I'm loving you. It's not the way she received it. Words of affirmation. Of course, she loved to be complimented, but that's not what did it for her. Now on the flip side, she would love me through acts of service. So doing things for me, doing things for our family, laundry, all these other things. And quality time. So when we were one-on-one, you know, and I love spending time with her as well, but it didn't speak volumes to me like the other two did. So it was almost like she was speaking Chinese and I was speaking Swedish. You know, it's like we were speaking two different languages. Once we both read that book and really understood, like, oh, this is the way I need to be loved. And this is the way I need to be loved. Now, I help out way more around the house, you know, so like dishes and dinners, and I make her breakfast and I'll bring her her coffee in the morning. When we go out on date nights, I put my phone away because I also found out the hard way that if I have my phone out and she's talking to me, it's just as impactful as if I were to make a sexual advance towards her and she physically pushed me away. It's so insulting and it hurts her feelings. Like, I'm not important enough. Like, your Facebook status update is more important than me wanting to talk to you about our family. So like, you know, she would just, and just in a very genuine way, she's like, that's kind of what it feels like. It hurts. I'm like, wow. Okay. I need to change that. And then, so now my wife knows, like, I love to be complimented. I love to be appreciated. So she does those things. And as far as physical, we have a great physical intimate relationship because she knows that's the way I need to, even the way she wakes me up in the morning, she literally, like, I always sleep on my side or on my stomach and she'll take both of her hands and either rub my arm, like just in a really loving way, or just rub my back. And I'm just like, oh my God, that's like the best way in the world to wake up. You know, especially if your love language is physical touch, it's like this awesome loving wave that for your wife to wake you up. And, so it's just a way of understanding. Now I will say this, it doesn't come naturally to me to do acts of service because I want to be physical with her. That's my default. And same with her. She didn't grow up in a family that complimented a lot. So she always has to be like, okay, if I'm thinking he looks good, you know, in that shirt or whatever else, I should tell him. And she always tells me, she's like, well, I always think that stuff. I'm just not good at telling you that stuff. And I was like, well, it makes me feel loved when you tell me. So it's just understanding. So it literally, that book and that understanding would probably save half the marriages in the world. I mean, I'm not kidding, because you're speaking each other's language.